In this video, I'd like to discuss the determinants of price elasticity of demand. And to do so, I will make a summary of the different determinants so that you can have everything consolidated in one video. So with that being said, let's start. I listed them over here, four determinants. I will go through each of them and I will discuss them and make some notes. So the first one, the number and closeness of substitutes will determine how elastic the demand is, meaning that when you have a lot of different options or alternatives to a certain product, you are more likely to switch to consuming that product than when you do not have those alternatives. In other words, if you have apples to consume, but you can equally enjoy bananas and oranges and many other fruits, then changes in the price levels of apples, so if apples become more expensive, basically, you're more likely to consume bananas instead or oranges or any other fruit. So therefore, because you have many substitutes for apples and because you consider the fruits to be similar in taste to apples, you will have an elastic demand of apples. In other words, you are very reactive to change in prices of apples. So over here, if we have substitutes, okay, if we have substitutes, the more substitutes we have, so substitutes, the number of substitutes goes up, then as a result, the price elasticity of demand also goes up. And the opposite logic holds true. If the substitutes, the number of substitutes we have goes down, so we don't really have alternative options, then the price elasticity of demand goes down as well, meaning that our demand becomes inelastic, since we do not have any other options to choose from, so we will consume the same product even though it becomes more expensive. Hope this makes sense. Now let's have a look at the second one, necessity of the product. Now, how much you need a product will equally determine how reactive you are to changes in prices of that product. So if you really need a product on a daily basis, then you are more likely to pay higher prices for it, or you are not going to adjust your consumption even if the product is more expensive. For instance, we all need water to drink. So even if there would be expensive water on the market, even if water rises in price for whatever reason, then we would still buy it because we just need it so much. If we need a certain medical treatment and it helps us live better, it helps us survive basically, we are not likely to change our consumption of that medical treatment. We're not likely to give it up even though it's more expensive, since our life depends on it. So the higher the necessity of a product it is for our well-being, the less elastic the demand is. And the opposite logic holds true. The less necessary the product is, the more elastic the demand is, the more sensitive we are to changes in prices. So over here, as a summary, as a note, we would have the following relation. The more necessary it is, so as necessity of the product is higher, then the price elasticity of demand is lower. Whereas if the necessity is lower, we don't really need that product very much, then the price elasticity of demand is higher. We will have a relatively elastic demand because we can switch to products that we can equally consume. Now, the definition of the product. This is an ambiguous one. This is something that I notice students struggle with. How you define a product is gonna determine how elastic the demand is. Consider the following example. Imagine if I consider the price level of meat as a product. I just consider consumption of meat. Meat is a broad concept. Meat can have, or meat can include beef, pork, chicken, lamb, and many others that I'm not listing right now. But when I just talk about the price level of the meat, even though meat might become more expensive, it's a pretty demanded product in most people's cuisines. Most people have some meat every day. So therefore, even though meat might become more expensive, we're still going to consume it. So as a result, the elasticity of demand, the price elasticity of demand for meat as a product is going to be relatively low. We're not going to react to a lot, to the changes in prices. On the other side, if I were to consider beef and then chicken and let's say pork, well, now I just subdivided the meat into three categories, so therefore I have alternatives. I'm not considering I'm not considering meat as a whole. I'm considering the price levels of each product. So if the price level of beef, price of beef goes up, I can go for more chicken or I can go for more pork. Meaning that my consumption of beef is going to diminish. I will be more reactive to the price levels of the beef since I can go for substitutes. So the more specific I define my product, like in this case, the more elastic the demand is. So to make a small note over here underneath, I'm gonna write that, let me just change the color real fast. The more specific, okay, more specific definition, or let me just say specificity, to save time and to save the note, to make it shorter, specificity. If the specificity, the definition of the product is more specific, then the price elasticity of demand of that specific product is going to be higher as well. However, if we're not specifying the product very well, specificity, like just keeping a broad concept of the product like meat, the price elasticity of demand is going to be relatively low because a broader category, we still need a broad category for most products. Like we need food, okay? We need meat as a broad category. We need furniture, but then furniture itself could be chairs and armchairs. So if chairs become too expensive, we might buy more armchairs for our house. That sort of example. Hope this makes sense. And finally, the time period considered. So basically what this means, let me just go a bit higher. If we have a change in the price level of, let's say, apples, since I talked about apples today already in this video, if the price level of apple goes up, in reality, we're not going to immediately adjust our consumption, because if we are used to apples, if we are loyal consumers of apples, we like them very much, we're still willing to pay a bit higher prices. But if that price level keeps rising and we realize that we're spending too much money on apples, we start considering eating bananas, tasting dates, tasting oranges, tasting pineapples, and therefore, over the longer period of time, over the longer run, we are starting to decrease the consumption of apples and switch to alternatives. Meaning that in the short run, okay, in the short run, our price elasticity of demand is fairly low, okay, because we're not adjusting our consumption immediately, but over the long run, after we consider alternative products to consume, we are more likely to adjust our consumption and therefore to try other products and therefore to change towards those products, meaning that we are more reactive to the changes in the prices. So the price elasticity of demand is higher. Hope this all makes sense, and we are done.